we have all recalled memories of past events at some point in our lives. But sometimes the memories we possess of them seem to be far from the actual reality. For example, most people remember the line, "Luke, I am your father," from Star Wars, The Empire Strikes Back, or the line, "Life is like a box of chocolates," from the movie Forrest Gump. However, these memories are far from the truth. In Star Wars, Darth Vader actually says, "No, I am your father." And the line from the movie Forrest Gump is actually, "Life was like a box of chocolates." Not only just lines from movies, but entire historical events are often incorrectly recalled by many people across the world. The best example of this is the death of the former South African president, Nelson Mandela, who was believed to have passed away in prison sometimes during the 1980s. Many people around the world firmly believe that Mandela in fact passed away in prison and insist that they remember the news coverage of his death. But in reality, he passed away in 2013 after serving 27 years in prison in 1990. So what is going on here? How are so many people recalling the exact same wrong memories? This shared false memory phenomenon is now referred to as the Mandela Effect, named after the South African president, Nelson Mandela. So let's take a look at what the Mandela Effect really is. But before we begin, be sure to subscribe to our channel for more content ahead. The Mandela Effect got its name when Fiona Broom, a self-described paranormal consultant, described how she remembered the former South African president Nelson Mandela dying in the 1980s in prison. She could even remember news coverage of his death and even a speech from his widow about his death. But in reality, this never happened. Now, it wouldn't be such a big deal if only one person remembered it wrong. But in Broom's case, there were thousands of people who remembered the exact same details of Nelson Mandela's death as her. So in 2010, this shared false memory phenomenon was dubbed the Mandela Effect by Fiona Broom. Ever since its conception, there have been hundreds of cases of the Mandela Effect. Some of these include the American children's cartoon being spelled as Berenstain Bears instead of Berenstain Bears, and the famous line from Snow White, "Mirror, mirror on the wall," actually being "Magic mirror on the wall." So what exactly is going on here? How can so many people be having the same false memories? Well, according to some, the Mandela Effect could be the result of the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics. They believe that if there are an infinite number of universes alongside our own, then it must be possible for these false memories to be correct in another universe. So our memories are somehow crossing over from other universes where these false memories are indeed correct. This sounds like a wonderful idea. However, there are some problems with it. Although it is very plausible that there may be an infinite number of universes that exist due to quantum fluctuations, there is no evidence of energy or information leaking from one universe to the other. In fact, the laws of physics absolutely forbid any contact between these parallel universes. Laws of quantum mechanics and thermodynamics strictly state that no energy or information can be created or destroyed within a closed system. Since all of these parallel universes are closed systems, it is safe to assume that nothing can leave or enter them from an external source. Not only do these laws hold for parallel universes, but also for multiverses that are a product of string theory. This means that the shared false memories are most certainly not the result of consciousness or thoughts being transferred from parallel realities. Another idea that is quite popular about the Mandela Effect is that we may be living in a simulation. Some believe that the false memories we have are actually correct, but glitches in the matrix caused it to be different than what most people remember. Others believe that the programmer of the simulation may have reprogrammed some events according to their own liking. However, there's a slight problem here as well. If we were all living in a simulation, then that means that the simulation would have absolute control over every action and every thought that we can possibly have. We ourselves would be simulations, and there would be no way of knowing anything beyond what a programmer decides to program in us. So, if by some chance a glitch actually occurred in the Matrix, the programmer could simply rerun the program from the point the glitch happened and remove the glitch very easily. No one would or ever could know that a glitch existed in the first place. So unless the programmer intended to program the memories of the Mandela effect in us all, we most certainly wouldn't know about it. Now, if parallel realities and simulation theories weren't enough, some believe that the Mandela effect could be the result of time travelers messing with details of the past, which affects the future we occupy. Others believe it might be the product of black magic, but none of these theories are currently testable, so no one can really be sure of what really is the case. But according to scientists, the Mandela effect may be nothing more than a natural phenomenon. When studying memory-related functions of the brain, scientists found that memories are organized in the brain such that similar memories are stored in nearby neurons. For example, many people thought that the WWE wrestler Rikishi had passed away from a heart attack. However, it wasn't Rikishi that passed away, it was his cousin Umaga, who was also a WWE wrestler. But because they were so similar in appearance and their wrestling styles, memories of them must have been stored in the same parts of the brain and must have got jumbled up during recall. Another possible explanation is that our memories are constructed from bits of information we interact with over time. So instead of playing back a recording of a certain memory, our brain reconstructs past memories from storage. This means similar, unrelated memories can also get triggered in the process and cause a big mix-up. For example, many people claim to have had Jiffy peanut butter, whereas in reality it is actually called Jif. Since another brand of peanut butter by the name of Skippy was also available during this time, scientists believe that our brains must be combining two different bits of information to come up with a false memory. Another example of this would be the monocle on the Monopoly guy. He actually never had one. But since it was a famous piece of history in movies and TV shows, people must have combined the memory of the Monopoly guy and the monocle. Last but not least, misinformation can also cause such false beliefs. People tend to believe information that fits within their narrative. So false and misleading claims on the internet can often have a powerful impact on people's opinions and the formation of certain memories. So in short, human memory is not very reliable and can oftentimes be manipulated by false narratives, suggestions, and blatant misinformation. In fact, a study found that people actually believe rumors and lies over the actual truth 70% of the time when misinformation and false narratives were present. And that brings us to the end of this video. What do you think of the Mandela effect? Do you think someone is covering up the truth? What other examples of the Mandela effect can you think of? Let us know in the comment section down below. Also, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel if you enjoy videos like these. Until then, we'll see you in the next one.